Hi my loves, welcome back to my channel. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today we are going to be talking about this insane transit that is happening that we are all currently under the influence. Please excuse the fact that I'm sitting in my robe. I legit was so excited that I didn't even want to take any additional time to figure out a cute outfit to wear, and it honestly just feels like it's you and I hanging out in my living room right now. Well, technically it's my bedroom, my sitting area in my bedroom, and we're just talking about this transit and how it's going to be influencing us. So that being said, the transit that it is that I'm referring to is Sun conjunct Pluto. Now, this is so powerful, and it almost, when I look at it, the first thing that I'm feeling and the first thing that I'm seeing, it's almost like you are this toothpaste tube and something is just getting squeezed out of you, whether it be the truth, whether it be this deep purge, whether it be emotion, or maybe it's not you, maybe it's something in your environment, but when it happens, it is legit life-changing. The crazy thing is that last night, even though this transit is exact today, and today is Friday, January the 11th, 2019. But even though this transit is technically today, we have been feeling this the majority of the middle to now, and we're gonna feel it into this weekend because, again, the aspect and the transit could be exact in this one moment, but they're still nearing each other. And the sun represents where our energy is being focused, where all of our collective energy is being focused. Now, the sun has been moving through the sign of Capricorn. Capricorn is very serious, it's very structured, it wants stability, and it wants to invest, it wants long-term, it wants rules, it wants things to be organized. I mean, I could go on and on. And the sun, all of us have been very serious. In fact, the universe and the cosmos are requiring us to really take accountability for ourselves, to really step into positions of responsibility, meaning like, what is it that I should be doing? That's what it is that I should be doing. And that's always around this year, because when the sun moves to the sign of Capricorn, it's a sign and a signal of the times, which is a time of using your resources, knowing what it is that you can use that's going to benefit you, and anything that does not serve you just gets tossed to the wayside because it doesn't serve a purpose. And that's what Capricorn energy brings into all of our lives, and that's why it makes us so serious and responsible. And again, wants you to take accountability for your actions, because it's an honest assessment of what will serve you and what doesn't. And when we have Pluto, Pluto is the planet of death and transformation. And what Pluto does is it really dives into the meat of something. It wants to dive into the matter of it. You know, it doesn't care about fluff. It doesn't even look at fluff. In fact, it's like, you know, if there's something here that's distracting you, or, you know, you have it here for, you know what makes me feel good? And Pluto says, it makes you feel good? I don't care. Like, that thing is nothing. It just flicks it away from you. This is where we see breakdown in relationships. We see breakdown within ourselves. And the reason why this is because Pluto is identifying aspects of yourself that are weak. It will look at your ego and say, fuck your ego. I don't care about your ego. This is the truth of who you are. This is the truth of your situation. And I will squeeze it out of you so that you see it, so that you know it, so that you can't deny it anymore. And from that, your whole world will change. This transit is very, very intense for most people. And it can create this purge. It can create this reality shift. And I wait for these types of transits, because once this happens, your entire life can change overnight based upon this realization, or based upon this like total game changer type of vibe. And that's what Pluto brings. Once whatever it is gets revealed or brought up to the surface, it's just total, you know, 180 from there on out. In fact, if you have this in your chart, in your natal chart, or if you have it within your solar return, which is the next thing I want to talk about today. I have on my agenda to film this. R. Kelly, like, his birthday was on Tuesday. He's under the influence of Sun conjunct Pluto. And basically, Pluto brings the truth. It pushes down. It pushes down so hard to probe, to find the realness. Like, what is to the point where you're almost under a scope, like a microscope. And why that is because the universe, or people around you, or the cosmos, they want to know you know, what is going on. They want to expose, they want to reveal. So if there are aspects within your life that you are trying to hide, this is when those things get brought to the surface. If you are normally a person who's pretty confined and pretty contained and has a hard time like stepping into your personal power, this transit will push you into your personal power. You have to step in it, you have to own it. If there's something going on with the government or a business or an organization, this is when, you know, the weight of that starts to come in and starts to crush. And I know that sounds really intimidating. It sounds really like problematic and troublesome, but in reality, I look at this and I feel like if I want to be the best version of myself and I want to, bring the best and have the best within my life, or if there's certain things around me that have been held constricted and confined that have been off limits to me, or whatever the case is, this transit will push people to the point where they are so uncomfortable, they have no choice but to break out of their normal ways, their normal routines, in order to do what is necessary. And for me, I am always the most brutally honest person. I operate from my heart and I communicate from my heart. I don't hold anything back. So when I see transits like this, and I'm very thorough. So when I see a transit like this, I'm like, okay, what do we have? What's gonna get revealed? What, you know, who has been not hiding things from me? And this doesn't have to be a negative thing. It doesn't have to be a bad thing. It's just, you know, the truth of something. Like if there's something that's been sitting on your heart, the truth of that gets revealed. So it's no longer, you know, wrapped up pretty and behind this mask. Like, I wanna see who you are. I wanna know what it is that you've been feeling, what it is that you've been thinking. Talk to me about it, tell me about it. This transit will help that to happen, believe it or not. And for some people, it is uncomfortable, but it is the biggest purge, the biggest relief, and it gets taken off of your shoulders. The other thing is, like, again, this issue of like power control and manipulation and, you know, stepping into your own identity, stepping into your own essence, the core of your being. For those of you guys who are working with goddess energy right now, or masculine energy, you know, highlighting those aspects within yourself, the God within you, this aspect is gonna really help you to connect with your inner nature, because again, all of who you are gets kind of pushed down and exposed. I always look at this, I was telling my client this yesterday when I was looking at her chart, because her chart was so interesting, but it's almost like if you have a pimple, this is a really gross metaphor, but it's a perfect metaphor, but if you have a pimple and you're pushing it up, like a whitehead, I know this is so gross, but if you're pushing on this whitehead, it wants to pop open and the muck of it is revealed. So if you're doing deep healing exercises or deep healing practices, or there's a truth or whatever this is, something gets pushed up to the surface. And then if it's not pushed out and up, it's pushed down. It's the pressure of it gets pushed down so that the energy has the ability to change. Again, whatever it is that happens here, it can change your life literally overnight. This is not who you were is not who you will be moving forward. And it's always for your highest and greatest good if you are open to it. Again, if you fight any of the transits, it's going to be more painful than it needs to be, and you just kind of drag yourself through the muck. It's like getting dragged across rocks. Like, just lift your feet up and allow the universe to guide you and follow in the footsteps of where the universe is trying to take you, versus the universe kind of dragging you and saying, we're going this way regardless. That's the thing about Pluto and Saturn energies in general. They tell you, this is where we're going. This is what needs to happen. And some of you guys just don't want to follow it. You want to fight it. And that's when you find the most trouble for yourself. So I hope that makes sense. I did want to keep this video short, but again, use this transit to really connect with what your heart's true desires are, to call them forward, to step into your personal power, to say what it is that you want, to step into like this authoritative role. And then also allow yourself to be manipulated by this, meaning like allow yourself to be changed, because it's for your highest and greatest good. Be open, be vulnerable, it's okay. All right, so you can find videos like this and far more on my YouTube channel. Make sure that you're subscribed, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.